Dear students, I am Dr. Rajiv Sapre and this is the 37th audio for you. In this audio, I will discuss the topic sequences and series. In 10th standard also, you have studied this particular idea. In this case, you have studied about arithmetic progression. First, you must know what is sequence, right? And then, as you studied arithmetic progression, there are another two progressions that you have to work on. And those progressions are called geometric progression and harmonic progression. And then there are a lot of things. That means relation between these three progressions. Then there is something called arithmetico-geometric progression, results related to that. And lot of things. Then there is a concept called power series. Okay, sequence and series, these are two related things, and so this study is done together. So the first we will work on what is series or what is sequence first. So remember that sequence is collection of numbers arranged in some order and obtained in succession according to some definite rule. Many words in this definition are important. It is collection of numbers, right? Arranged in some order. So any collection of numbers is not sequence. There must be some order, right? And the next number in that sequence is obtained by some definite rule. So suppose I give the rule, say n square, where n belongs to set of natural numbers. You know, first natural number is 1, so it will be 1 square. Then it will be 2 square. Then it will be 3 square. Then 4 square and so on. This will go on. So 1 square is 1, then 4, then 9, then 16, then 25. See, this is a collection of numbers. And some order is there in that arrangement. Right? And when you know 1 square, 2 square, 3 square, 4 square, immediately you can tell that next number is 5 square. So there is some rule which governs this sequence. Okay? So, individual numbers forming a sequence are called terms of that sequence, right? And since there is order, since their order is important, they are usually denoted by T1, then T2, then T3, then T4, and so on, Tn, and so on. T means term, and which term? First term, then you will write it as T1, second term, T2, etc. Actually, any sequence when you take, it is a function. Sequence is a function whose domain is set of natural numbers. You know what are natural numbers, n, 1, 2, 3 and so on. It's the domain of that function. So if that function is f, the first term will be f of 1. Second term will be f of 2, third term will be f of 3, like this it will go on. Now instead of writing that f of 1, f of 2, f of 3, etc., we write t1, t2, t3 and so on. And general term is denoted by tn, and in circular bracket or triangular bracket, it depends what you will prefer, but that is the general term. And you have to define whole sequence by writing what is Tn. So in this particular example that I gave, Tn I will write as n square. And then you put different values of n from the set of natural numbers. If I take say Tn as 2n minus 1. Right? Now when you put n is 1, I get 2 into 1 minus 1, which is 1. When I take t2, it will be 2 into 2 minus 2. So it will be, minus 1. So it will be 3. Then t3 when I take, it will be 2 into 3 minus 1, 5. So 1, 3, 5, I will get sequence of odd numbers. Is the idea clear? So whenever you take any sequence, it is a function whose domain is set of natural numbers. And as domain is infinite set, every sequence contains infinitely many terms. Remember, any sequence contains infinitely many terms. This idea must be very clear. Now, this sequence is called arithmetic progression if something happens. Sequence is called geometric progression if something happens. So that is every arithmetic progression, every geometric progression, every harmonic progression is basically a sequence. That is why you started with the study of sequences. And in case of sequence, you must know that it is a function whose domain is set of natural numbers always. And as set of natural numbers is infinite, terms in the sequence are always infinite. And generally, sequence is denoted in a circular bracket Tn. Tn is nth term of that sequence. So you have to define a sequence by giving some formula for Tn. And in that formula will be in terms of n. Okay. And when you put different values of n, you will get terms of the sequence. This is the theory. Now, what is arithmetic progression? So you know now that any arithmetic progression is basically a sequence. So a sequence T1, T2, T3 and so on, Tn and so on, in which T1 is A, first term, T1 taken as A, and Tn plus 1 minus Tn is constant. Tn plus 1 means what? N plus 1th term minus Tn, that means nth term. It is constant for all n belonging to capital N. Then it is called arithmetic sequence or arithmetic progression. It means a sequence in which difference of any two consecutive terms is always constant. Difference of any two consecutive terms is always constant is called arithmetic progression. The constant given by Tn plus 1 minus Tn is called the common difference of that arithmetic progression, and it is usually denoted by A. It is usually denoted by D. A is reserved for the first term and D is the common difference. Okay. So if A is the first term and D is the common difference of the arithmetic progression, then its nth term is given by Tn is equal to A plus n minus 1 into D. N minus 1 inside bracket. So Tn is equal to A plus n minus 1 into D. Okay, if A is the first term and D is the common difference of the arithmetic progression, then the sum of first n terms is denoted by Sn. S stands for sum, and how many terms we have summed? N terms. So suffix n. Sn, the formula is n upon 2 into bracket 2a plus n minus 1 into d. 2a plus n minus 1 into d is inside bracket, and that is to be multiplied by n by 2. Now out of that 2a, I can break as a and a addition. So it will be a plus n minus 1 into d. And a plus n minus 1 into d is the nth term. Right? So we can also denote sum of n terms by n upon 2 into bracket first term plus nth term. First term plus nth term. So this is also sometimes useful as a formula for sum of n terms of arithmetic progression. So now there are see, you have to, this is a definition, okay, this is all a definition of what is nth term, what is SN, what is arithmetic progression, what is A, what is D, etc. is okay. But suppose any sequence is given to you and you want to prove that sequence whose nth term is Tn, some Tn is given to, some formula for Tn is given, and if you want to prove that it is an arithmetic progression, then what is supposed to be done? You have to show that difference between any two consecutive terms is constant. So what we will do, Tn plus 1 minus Tn you will calculate, and you will show that it is constant. What is, how to calculate Tn plus 1? Very simple, whatever is formula for Tn is given, in that formula, in place of n, you put n plus 1. You will get Tn plus 1. Okay. And so when you show that Tn plus 1 minus Tn is always constant, then the sequence is in arithmetic progression. So this is the theory of arithmetic progression. So suppose I have given three numbers A, B and C. Okay, and I am told that these numbers are in arithmetic progression. Then definitely what I can say, difference between two consecutive terms is constant. This is our definition. So A, B, C. So B minus A will be equal to C minus B. And when you say that B minus A is equal to C minus B, naturally you can make the adjustments and we can say that 2b is equal to a plus c. So whenever three numbers are in arithmetic progression, the double of the middle term is the addition of first and third term. Okay, suppose I take three numbers 5, 8 and 11. See, these are in arithmetic progression. 5, 8 and 11. Why? Because 5 plus 3 is 8, 8 plus 3 is 11. So common difference is what? 3. See now, double of the middle term, 8 plus 8 is the middle term, so double of that is 16. And what is addition of first and third term? 5 and 11, again it is 16. Right? So this property is very, very important. Whenever you have three numbers and suppose they are in arithmetic progression, then middle term, double of that is equal to sum of first and third term. We will use this in solving problems in future. Now many problems are asked where find the three numbers in arithmetic progression, find four numbers in arithmetic progression, find five numbers in arithmetic progression. In such cases, whenever it is a problem on three numbers, about arithmetic progression and three numbers, then those numbers, if you take A minus D, A and A plus D, then your problem solving will become simpler. A minus D, A and A plus D. See, these three numbers are in arithmetic progression because when you add D to A minus D, you get middle term A, and to that when you add D, you get A plus D. Suppose they ask you the problems on four numbers in arithmetic progression, then you should take those numbers as A minus 3D, A minus D, A plus D and A plus 3D. If they ask you problem on five numbers in arithmetic progression, then it is convenient to take the numbers as A minus 2D, A minus D, then A plus D and A plus 2D, like that. Remember, this is one way by which you can solve such problems conveniently, right? And suppose I have sum of n terms, I denote by SN, S capital N as a suffix. What it is? It is T1 plus T2 plus T3 plus and so on up to Tn. All the n terms are added. What is SN minus 1? That means sum up to first n minus 1 terms. It will be T1 plus T2 plus T3 up to Tn minus 1. So when you subtract SN minus SN minus 1, so from sum of first n terms, I will subtract sum of first n minus 1 terms, naturally I get nth term, that is Tn. So this is the formula for Tn. What it is? Tn is equal to Sn minus Sn minus 1. And this is true for all n greater than or equal to 2. Okay, so if I want to find nth term of the sequence when sum of n terms is given, then you have to use this formula. Tn is equal to Sn minus Sn minus 1. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this audio. Thank you.